Hello friends, how are you? Welcome back to this channel.
Hello.
I have my brother, Carlos.
Hmm.
My father. Today we're going to do a video about how we do grill here in Monterrey, Mexico.
Wow.
And that's why my brother Carlos, the chef Carlos, is with us. Very soon he's going to have his own channel. Kelken, please go to visit him. Subscribe. You're going to learn in there a lot of stuff about Mexican food, international food, Filipino food, no food, everything. Come on, join here. You're going to like it. I promise you. So let's do it. Okay, Chucky. Hi. We're ready to start. The first thing I'm going to do is to prepare the meat and the ingredients that we're going to eat.
Yeah.
We're going to show you what we're going to cook.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah! Okay, I'm going to cut that, don't worry.
Chucky, what we have in here?
This is a kind of sausage. It's the same thing that the normal sausage, but this is special to cook in the grill because we have the, it's not plastic, it's
some kind of skin.
Yeah, it's kind of, it's an interesting skin that prevents that explode in the grill and preserves the juice inside.
Wow.
How you prepare this? Cotta, you put some condiments?
No, nothing. Only we are going to cut in half.
Okay.
Retire the skin and put in the grill, not directly in the fire, but in the side of them.
Okay. The next one is, it's called arrachera, right?
Yeah, arrachera. The arrachera is...
It's beef, it's pork, what is this?
Everything is beef, the only the sausage is pork. It's part of the belly, and it's a cut mostly known for the softness. We are going to do a grill, traditional grill, not so sophisticated.
Mm.
So you can put lemon and salt,
okay,
and it's perfect. But we are going to use a fajita season.
Okay.
Yeah, to put in the two meats.
Oh.
This season have garlic, black pepper, white pepper, and cumin.
Perfect.
Okay.
Maybe it's, you know this one because it's more common. It's T-bone.
And the name was for the shape of the bone inside the meat.
What?
Normally we have a T right here.
You can see in here. In here, this is bone. It's called in here and going down in here. And the shape of the bone is like a capital letter T.
Yeah.
Wow.
And this is common here in Monterrey. And palmes is like two corn tortillas with beans and cheese inside.
Okay.
We're put in pork, pork.
Ah.
How do you say?
Hmm.
Fat?
Yeah, pork fat.
Okay.
Pork fat, and then in the grill, directly okay. To fire.
Perfect.
Finally, we have jalapeno peppers.
Sile.
Yeah.
This is sile.
What?
Cheese inside with bacon around the peppers.
Okay. Perfect.
And finally, our secret sauce. Our secret sauce have tomato, coriander, onion, preferably white onion, and serrano pepper.
Okay. Not much secret anymore. Let's prepare this.
Today we're going to do a traditional grilling meat. It's simple, it's easy, it's quickly.
Oh.
Anyway, you pay attention.
We are going to use the fajita sazonador. We are going to put a lot in the both sides. Just a few, okay? Right there, and right here, okay? If you can repose the meat for 10 or 15 minutes, just to absorb the season in the meat, much better.
Oh yeah, baby.
By the way, if you can put, or if you like to put just a little twist of beer, you can add a lot of flavors too, okay?
Twist of what?
Beer.
Beer?
Yeah.
Cerveza?
Yeah, cerveza.
Okay, ooh, okay.
Better, okay?
It's a tip.
Wow.
The arrachera is too special because we have two faces of the arrachera.
What?
The arrachera is more fatty in one of the sides than in the other.
So, we are going to put season in the way, in the face that we have more fat. This is going to be the first part directly in the grill.
Okay, you put in the grill the fatty part first.
Yeah, because if you put first the other way, the other side, you are not going to melt that fat.
The fatty, okay.
Yeah, the fatty, and prevents to make the meat more hard.
Okay. So it's a very good tip. When you start grill, any kind of meat, start with the side that is more fatty, okay?
Already finished to marinate our meat. We're going to stay right here in 10 or 15 minutes. The sausage, remember, doesn't need any condiments, just pure love.
What?
Pure love?
Yeah.
Remember. Okay, people, next step, open the fire.
Oh, maybe light my fire.
What is the technique you use to create fire?
The first way to start the charcoal is to put a tower in the middle, on the tower, put some kind of napkins with oil.
It's napkins with
cooking oil.
With cooking oil inside, in the middle. You can see the tower.
It's like a volcano.
Inside is pieces of napkin with cooking oil.
With cooking oil, okay? If you put alcohol, if you put another way to start fire, like starting fires with chemicals, the meat, when you grill, you're going to taste that flavor in your meat.
What?
It's not recommendable to put other
chemical?
Other combustibles.
Like gasoline or stuff like that.
Yeah, that's okay. Not recommendable.
Avoid the chemical, use more like natural.
The only thing that you need right now is a match. And put it inside
the volcano.
Side.
Okay, we have a problem, Houston. It is
ready.
Okay, you can see. Okay, come on, baby, light my fire. See?
And that's okay. The way.
Wow.
We're going to clean the grill with a piece of onion.
What?
Oh, it's not really
to
clean.
To make flavor?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course, it's not really clean.
It's not really clean.
I don't see soap in here.
No. Just remove the old particles of meat or
from other
grills, okay. Or to add
a little bit of flavor.
It's not flavor. How do you say it?
Essence?
When you smell? Yeah, essence.
Like an essence.
Yeah.
What?
Wash it.
Wow.
You smell it?
Okay, friends. Let's continue. Now it's time to put the hot dog or the sausage, the meat, everything in the fire. It's like tortilla with what is inside? In this particular palmet, we have cheese
and beans.
Cheese and beans. In the outside of the palmet is a little bit of
pork fat.
In this part. So at the moment that they cook, it's greasy and
a flavor and doesn't dry.
And now the remaining of the
meat. One rule, you need to put the meat in the charcoal in the grill. Using your hand, you can taste the temperature of the grill. You need to hold more than 2 seconds twice in your hand and That tells you that the grease is ready to the meat. Okay,
I didn't know that. Today I learned something new.
As we talk, the film is the first to touch the grill.
Remember, the film is the part of the meat that has more fat.
Oh.
That's all.
Yeah. Chucky, what is the right moment to turn the meat in the grill? How do you know when you have to turn it?
Okay, well, it's going to depend about what term do you want your meat.
Not have to do about the bleeding of the meat.
No, it doesn't matter. You want medium term, 2 minutes each side. Do you want 3/4, 5 minutes each side? And do you want well done? Do you need to put a lot of times until you do you see that it's dry in the top of the
meat? Okay. Remember that.
Yummy.
Okay, friends. This is the end of this video. We enjoy doing this. Thank you to Chef Chucky. Please subscribe to his channel. I'm going to leave the link of his channel in the description of this video, so you can go right now. You're going to learn a lot with him. He's a very good chef. But subscribe first to our channel, okay? Thank you very much. Thank you, Chucky.
Thank you. Thank you, MexPeel team. We hope to see you soon in my channel.
Or the wine is done.
Done.
Thank you again, and see you in our next video. Mwah, we love you guys.
Bye-bye. Bye. Good morning, good afternoon, or good night.
Enjoy.
¿Qué fue el inicio?
Sí.
Ya no volvemos a ver.
Tú ya no, papá.